It doesn't matter who we are. What matters is our plan.
Welcome back. Now, in the last video, I defeated the dragon. I defeated the dragon in the last video. And in this video, I'm just in the area now where I defeated the dragon. Probably so it teleports you elsewhere, so. Oh, I didn't see that. So we've got an ancient dragon great shield there. Didn't see that too. Yeah, I didn't see that on the edge. The area is now free of the dragon's reign, so I can do what I want. There's a bell there. I don't think you can actually do anything with the bell, and there's nothing around the bell. All the items that are around are all down here. A dummy pie. Now the sneakiest one of all though is just down here. Should see there's a ring of steel protection there. It's a very sneaky ring. So after doing that, I'm just going to have a look on that ledge and make sure there's nothing there. I don't believe there is. I can't see anything, I don't think we can go down it. We can go down onto that ledge as well. I should be able to just do this bit and then start off from the second bonfire really. The best thing to do is probably let him come at you. What would have happened is these two guys would have came out of the corner originally. All we really needed to do was kill them, but I used the dragon to my advantage, which the dragon actually killed them for me. And then the only other place where there's an item should be in here. I should have covered the top bit, because the dragon can get me on the top bit. So anything that was on the top bit I should have already got. So we've just got a chunk, and now I'm just going to use a homeward door and start from the second bonfire. When we go in this next room, it's got plenty of surprises in store, but if you know what's going to happen, not so much of a surprise, is it? There's a guy that will get summoned directly. There's an enemy that summons him. You need to get to this enemy. I'm going to show you where he is. Directly run to the left. Hearing him summoned there. They don't do an awful lot to you. You go up here. There we go, there he is. Easy enough to kill. However, whoever he summoned is still around, so we need to go sort him out. And he should be a sword fighter and he should be down there. When I originally came in this area, the first time I ever came in, Is someone that Pavel guy? Come to the Havel guy later, so it makes a little difference whether he summons the Havel guy or not, because it gives you like Havel shield and whatever. Like I say, it makes very little difference. So we've got a lift here. I think this is the useless one. I'm not sure whether it is or isn't. Yeah, it's the most useful thing that we're on about. It doesn't really do a right lot. Take you to a bonfire or anything. There is a bonfire and it is sort of close. Not close enough for me to actually use that lift. A bit too close for comfort there, and actually I've realised how useful that lift can be, just thinking about it, because I could actually kill all the guys in the back and come up that lift without actually dealing with that sword guy, but beyond that I should be sort of alright for the moment anyway. You come here and you do your Path of the Dragon gesture. See, you're long enough, you should get a ring. So, and that will make the day harder because it gives you 100% more damage. So if you fancy a challenge, you can wear that ring. But I'd suggest not to do it. This area is where the name of the king is, but this armor, this Dragon Slayer spear can actually get to without being in there. But the whole area will open up after you face the Nameless King. As we go down here and proceed onwards, there's a guy on the left here who thinks that he's going to jump on you. A few kicks on there still. And then you've got another guy. There's two guys there. Really want them to come to you, I'd suggest just walk backwards and let them come. They're very sort of defensive guys, these. They want you to come to them. That's the way they play their game. Very defensive. Quite a lot to do now with using so many Esther's shards so early on. I'm just hoping that I can do it. I were only meant to get one of them guys' attention, but I ended up getting both. But it caused a little damage to me, thankfully. Now, we do want to get this guy. It's just easy getting in from there, because when you come round here and you see that big guy, that other guy's going to come behind you. It's a lot of hard work, and somehow, I don't know how he can do this, but he can do his swing, he can manage to hurt you even though you've blocked it. Only this one, and he doesn't have any struggling with the other one. And I've lost a lot more health than I really wanted to. We've got a lot to do with so little health. Still got a dragon to face. So as we go up, this should be something. Get another great ring there, stone plate, thunder stone plate one. Not much down here as such. We're going to go in here. I believe there's some crystal lizards. I'm sure there's another guy somewhere around. This isn't a mimic in the meantime. I don't check a chest is going to be this time. Now for certain that isn't in it. Now you can get to that, but not through this way. And here, the best thing to do is them things like rock Bulbasaurs or something I'm going to call them. Like that. Call it a Bulbasaur just because it sounds good. There's plenty of these on the way up here. My items down there, so this is where a dragon turns up. And I can get this item. Remember that this dragon. What I'm better doing is letting the breeze get higher. They were right, a lot of damage really to me, fire. I've got fire armor and I've got fire shield as well, so try as you like. can get his leg. He won't do a lot of damage on his leg. Head. Materials for doing that dragon. It's very worth doing. As you go up here, I'm going to change my. Because I have got some in storage, but I really won't be using the fire arrows, feather, or wooden. Wooden, probably. Use a lot of wooden arrows. So what we're doing is we're going to try and I've only got one Estus Shard here now. Now what I'm doing is trying to get them to come down one at a time. There's four of these guys here. I'm getting these down one at a time. Really? Yeah. You always thought I'd get you on the third attack, I'm not gonna lie. Another one. That. When you go through here, I don't think there's any items, I'll just have a quick check. I don't believe there is. When you go through here, you're going to have another one of them guys that summon people. And this time you're going to have to roam quickly around. It's not going to be the same sort of guy. He's going to summon that guy there. Here he comes. He's going to give you a go. Rapier, they're in every single one of these games, and that's pretty much smooth sailing. Now, I'm not going to ring this bell yet. This takes you to the Nameless King, but there is another area that I want to cover before that. It's down here. I'm just going to go back to Firelink Shrine first. I'm going to be quick straight away in this area because I want to get the attention of this guy first. He was summoning here. He was the summoning. Now, I could use him for the Nameless King, but I don't really need him for the Nameless King. He's actually there in this area easier. Go down here first, which is what I'm going to do. There might be some items in this room. Remember that it's there. I don't think there's anything else. As we go up here now, what do I need to do? Get the attention of this guy. Got his attention. Try again. So as soon as you get that guy's attention, you'll get another two big bastards that are going to come down. Now he'll just wait there, so you're probably best waiting for the big guy. If anything, maybe try and attract him in quicker. Anything else? Every time you said two attacks and them guys are gonna get stunned. So I'll get him, because I think he's gonna be more likely to run to me. I'll get him too. Room to me is quite beneficial to the guys. There's another guy that's coming down. Now he's going to come to me now. Don't know why. Another guy comes. Other guy left now with the shield. I'm gonna do a defensive thing. What? Yeah. Like I said, this summoning here is really to help you get up there. But I actually don't think there's a lot up here, to be honest with you. I might even leave the item at the end there. Because I don't really need it, and I could summon him for the boss fight. I'm not extremely certain of this, but I'm guessing that I can. Now I'm sure there's something down one of these sides. Oh. I got my souls back. Stupid little. So you get the dragon's ashes. It is very useful for something, but I can't remember what it is. I knew there were a good item down there. I'm not sure whether it's something to do with arrows or. Now, I can get this. And I think I've got to do the Path of the Dragon gesture here to get an item. But I'm not going to do it because I'm going to take that guy into the Nameless King boss fight, I think. I think he's going to be some help, isn't he? Nameless King is a very, very hard boss, and I actually did him on my own. But I am going to be struggling for no reason. So if I can summon that guy, I will. So I believe that's not a mimic either. I don't think there's a mimic at all in these areas at all. I'm going to go up these ladders, and up these ladders holds a familiar face from both Dark Souls, or a familiar armor set mainly. Well, this guy will not be easy. Now I'm going to use my magic. Just devastating. The best thing to do against him is probably try and get a back attack. It's going to be your best option. If this guy hits you, he's going to do some damage and he's going to knock some health off your defense as well. After a certain... I'm going to back up right now. I've been getting down so far. You can decide to put this rock stuff on. Decided to put it on now. You're probably better further away. You're mixing amazingly slow. Watch out for that kick. And it will wear off. And when it wears off, I'm not giving him a light on that. It's pretty much impossible to get a back attack on him while he's two-handing that weapon. So, as soon as he does start landing it, we start to try to hit him from the front. Hitting him from the front, gives you what causes the right lot of damage towards him. Oh, easily have hit me there. There we go. Did a lot better than the first time I faced him. Havel's Field, and I do believe it unlocks the Havel set, and you get a slab for your troubles too. Yeah, I do believe it unlocks the Havel set. And if you go down here, I believe. Fall down here, there is something of importance. Remember what it is, yeah, I can. Get it? Ah, so it's a miracle. So you need that miracle to get all miracles achievements. Oh well, it's an optional area. You're going to need that miracle. Now, I can't do a lot else. I'm going to use a homeward bone because I can't be arsed messing about and going around it all. Now, going forward here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually equip my Lovric shield there. ridiculously good with the lightning attacks, and this guy is a lightning based character. Now, I'm not sure whether the Son of Time will be here now. I don't know whether doing that bell automatically locks the summoning out. It doesn't. The summoning is still there. So I'm going to see if he follows me. I'm going to use him, or I'm going to try to use him. In the West to be using return home. To return home, so I suppose I can't use him after all. Which means I'm gonna have to try and do this the hard way. And boy is it hard. All you need to do is jump down onto here and you won't fall anywhere. I don't believe there's anything. And I'm not expecting to complete this first time, but I might do. See what happens. But is a nameless king. He's definitely. In my opinion, the Nameless King is the hardest boss in the game due to the fact that you can't summon anyone for the Nameless King. You unlock that last final bonfire. So, there should be a ring somewhere around here that I need. I'm gonna have to look around. It's a fairly big area. There's a few things around, I think. So there's one of them. Actually, if you notice before the boss fight, this is the one thing that you can see, all the Dragon Slayer armour. But there is, or should be, a Havel ring somewhere. There also should be an Ember. That should be the Ember. I am there. Oh no, it's a slab. Even better. Can't find Havel's ring. What I'm gonna do. I'll just show you where this Havel ring is, but it's actually at the one that I was looking for when I'm actually on the game plus. I've got them in the wrong order, this is why I didn't try looking for the other one. The Havel ring, before going up here. Here, you have a ring plus one, and that's all of the rings now on the plus game plus now, new game plus. All I need to do is pick off these DLCs now. So to access this DLC, you have to go to this.
No.
Oh. Yeah, you've got to access this DLC, you've got to go to the Cathedral Deep, but you can actually access this DLC that early in the game when you get to the Cathedral Deep. Oh. of these guys are too hard in this area, you shouldn't really have too much to do with them. I'm just going to make sure. It's really hard to understand where you're going, especially at the start of the game, but I'm just going to try and sort of come down there. So if I'm going this corner, I think it just leads to a dead end. Poison gun. And then there's that guy there, but really best bet if we just sort of go up here and stab this guy in the back. That guy should jump down on that place. That. So what I'll be trying to do is there's a couple of ways that you can go, but I'm die. To cover the wait for the vampire first, set the bonfire. I'll do two trips and pick two different ways. So as you go down this way, and you can pick this up before you drop. There we go. And when you go down here, there'll be some wolves. Can pick these off probably. These are gonna attack you no matter what you do. Alright for the moment, but there is plenty of more wolves, but it just looks like he's sat down, doesn't it? The first way that I'm going to take here is up this hill. And there will be other wolves up here as well. Howl, friends. You really want to watch them trees, although they can start moving very well. There's actually a big wolf as well. He's harder to kill. I'm not going to take it directly there because this is probably as far as we'll get to this video. So you'll see these. Very simple to kill. Don't go in front of them. Just don't be happy with them. Launch them sort of firefly things at you. Won't hurt. This is the easiest way down to the first bonfire. Yeah. enemies. They may not be quick, but they've got a lot of cry, yeah? You can also grab you as well. This is one that I believe can grab you. That. Like I said, this is going to be the easiest route. Watch out for that grab. You're alright. There must be another tree alive. They're probably the worst tree, because they're quite frightened. Badly. Go down to get that item. These little guys aren't too bad. You can get frozen weapons from that. But however, any of the sorceries in the DLCs do not count to any sort of trophy. DLCs in themselves, the trophies do not matter. Not one bit. Can't get behind her because she's right against the wall. See how she'll try and grab you. After getting hit by a fair few trees, you're sort of better at getting all of them. So this is the bottom of the road, and there should be a bridge there, and actually that bridge would lead you down to your first boss. And there is another way down here. You've come down this left-hand side in the other way, and that's how you get that iron there. I don't think it's all special though. So I'm gonna walk back to the first bonfire. Probably it'll be the end of this video, I imagine.